Hey, how's it going, everyone? Brad Smith here. Today, I want to talk about some quick tips for your sales funnel, some really big, large-scale funnels we've been working on. I want to simplify it a little bit for you so you can implement it for your business. Now, this is real tactics that you can actually use today. So number one, I want to go over where that traffic, where your ideal customers are coming from. You want to choose just one. If you are trying to target all the different channels, email, LinkedIn, ads, Google, it's really tough for you to target into the perfect audience. Now, I'm not saying you can't use all of them, but focus in on a main channel. Where are the main clients coming from? Are they coming from Facebook ads? Are they coming from Google search results? Where are they coming from? That way you can target and spend most of your time marketing and adding videos like this or blogs or copy to that one channel so you can build up your network and your brand. All right, tip number two is set up a lead capture form. One, now a lot of people have them on their contact page, on their sales funnel page, on their homepage. Set up just one. It's a lot easier to add that follow-up campaign if you just have one form to use. So set up the form, make sure you get notified, and make sure that the client gets followed up with. If you can get an instant notification on the one form, you can reply to them, they can be added to your campaign. It's gonna be a lot easier for you to manage, but also adds a clear direction for your customer. All right, tip number three, right into the form. As soon as someone fills out the form, they need to be added to the follow-up sequence so you can easily follow up with them. This is gonna be a lot more simple because you only have the one form, now you have the one follow-up campaign, and you can perfect that one. Focus on creating better relationships. It's about communication, asking them what they need help with, giving them videos, showing them videos that can help them with the demo, getting them into your Facebook group. So it's a lot easier with the one form, with the one funnel, perfect it, test it, and make sure it's creating a better relationship with your visitors. Tip number four, have that payment page ready. There's only gonna be less than 10% that are ready to buy the first day they come through your funnel, but make sure it's ready for that 10%. 90% will continue going, you can continue creating relationships with them, but then the 10% just ready to buy, ready to get signed up. If that's not in place, you're gonna lose out on the 10% possibly. They may not check the email the next day. They may not sign up again. So have the subscription or payment page ready. Multiple different softwares you can do that with. Let me know if you need help with them. Once you choose the right one, you can set up one-time payments or subscription payments. Tip number five, the most important. Like I mentioned in the last tip, was only about less than 10% are actually gonna go buy. What about the other 90%? Most likely, if you don't communicate and create a better relationship with them, they're not gonna buy from you. So make sure you continue to communicate after a lead comes through your funnel. You can do this through Messenger, through email, through phone calls, text messages. Continue building the relationship, thinking that, okay, they didn't buy today. They may not buy this week, but someday they'll buy. Some people will buy next week, next month, or next year if you create a good relationship with them. All right, so I hope these tips helped you today. Let me know if you have any questions and if I can help you. I have a case study program coming up next month. Just leave a comment, pilot program in the comments, and I'll send you the details. It's where we actually create this entire sales funnel for you, set it up, and make sure it's successful for you and your business. Talk to you soon.